In Luke chapter 5, when Jesus called Peter, he said, from now on, no more catching fish, you will be catching men for the Lord, for the kingdom. But now, Peter, not only he went to his old profession, leaving the mission of Jesus, he took also other disciples. But the merciful Savior, risen Christ, came where Peter was struggling in faith, where Peter was destroying the wonderful call God has given to him. The enemy perverted his mind, made him to run away from Christ, and made his life miserable, made him to sin against Christ, and made him to cry in guilt, and even refuse to come to meet the Lord. That's what sin does to people. It perverts our hearts. It takes away from our Lord, takes away everything that we have received from the Lord, and make our life a miserable one. In this miserable state, Judas even committed suicide. Yes. And the merciful God, risen Savior, who is full of hope, full of life, he is not here. He is not risen to tell us how sinful we are. He is here to tell us how, what a great life to which we belong. The risen Savior's message is, the world will pervert you. Don't move around your weakness. Enter into your strength. Enter into your life that is waiting for you. Who will forgive your sins. Who will cleanse you with his blood. And who will fill you with the Holy Spirit. Having accepted this good news, Peter's life once again bloomed with power and the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Now, the same Peter shares his own life with the Jews. Oh, my brethren, this world is a perverting world, he says. And this world will take away the wonderful call, the life which God has given to you. But there is a merciful God waiting for us. Our Jesus is a risen God. He not only died, whom you crucified, but now he is risen. He is with us. And for that we are the witnesses. We know what sin can do to a man. We know what the risen Savior can do to the sinners. We know when we return to the risen Savior, how the life can be bloomed once again. So you too, living in this perverted world, if you are not alert, the world will destroy you. There is only one way. Your Savior has not left you. Return to him. Repent for your sin. Recognize what your sin has done to you. And where are you moving to? Is it worth living? Check your life. Check your sinfulness. And remember, your God is here not to blame or tell the whole world how sinful you are, but he is there waiting for you to tell you, if you return to him in repentance, he can rebuild you. So those people began to ask, now what we can do? He said, repent. Recognize what your sin is doing to you and how you have lost all that of the Lord, and return to the Lord. The Lord's mercy will rebuild you. The risen Savior, he is risen from death to help you and me to rise up from death, to rise up from our sin, to receive the power of resurrection. Having received the power of resurrection, having received the good news that God still loves the world, God still forgives the world, God still rebuilds the lives of the sinners, you become the good news. Wherever you are, forgive the people. Wherever you are, be generous to people. Be kind to people. As your Lord is kind and merciful, you to become merciful and make this world a world of God, and you be His witness. My dear friends, last month I had gone to a place to preach the retreat. On the second day, I was almost preparing to go to the stage. I was waiting for the vehicle to come and pick me up. A man came running to me, bringing so much of support of fruits. We have got so many HIV children, old people, and he knew that, so he brought so much of support of fruits, which we could eat for a week. And he was full of joy. Know why? I know his story. He is a truck driver. He was driving from his place to Visakhapatnam, from Guntur to Visakhapatnam. And as he was traveling, one day he stopped his truck. It's morning, almost 2 o'clock. He stopped his truck to have a cup of chai. And he saw a girl who was selling cup of tea. They have a jug in that, they have the cup, they have the tea, and they are selling. And the father of the girl is also inside. He's so tired and he is sleeping inside. This man says, "Father, I stopped my truck. My cleaner who was with me already was drunk. I was also a little drunk. I got inside. And the girl saw us. We said I need a cup of chai. And as she was making, I did not know what happened to me. I went behind her. She was busy in her making tea. Put the clothes on her mouth and took her out. She was shouting, but nobody could hear. Her father was sleeping inside. And we tied her in a cot. And we raped that girl. And we did not know what happened. Then immediately we took the truck and we ran away. We went in the wrong route, different route. And we reached Vaisak in a... So nobody could catch us. We thought somewhat we escaped. And then the guilt, what I have done to a girl. She's almost like my daughter. What have I done? It killed me, Father. So 1 week I was fully drunk. Nobody knew why I'm behaving like that. I was behaving like a mad fellow. Then a phone call came from my home that my wife is in a very serious condition. I was wondering, how can my wife be in a serious condition? Because I was there at home for 10 days. I took my wife, who is pregnant, and the doctors told me that everything is normal, baby is normal. It's almost 9th month, so everything is normal. Now why she's admitted in the hospital and the doctors are saying I have to come immediately? It's very serious. I didn't understand, Father. So my boss arranged a car as he was sending some people to Hyderabad. So he sent me in that car. So I rushed home by the time my wife was admitted in the hospital. The doctors were scratching their heads saying, we do not know what to do. The baby inside looks very strange. I said, it's not possible. 10 days ago only we came to the doctors and we took x-ray. The baby is normal. And with a lot of difficulty, a girl child was born. Father, can you imagine? That girl was looking like almost like a monkey. Hair is grown up. With a little baby, how can the hair grow like this? Very strange. The way the face and everything. I cried. I knew. It's my son. My son is coming behind me. Sirach 21 verse 2 says, your sin will meet you. It's like a snake. It will bite you. That is the work of the enemy. He perverts our minds. He perverts our lives. And he destroys all the blessings that God has given to us. I cried and wept. Father, do you remember that time only? We came home. I was so much worried. Everybody will come to see my wife and the child. That's why we came to Mainabad for retreat. Now, then I remembered, yes. And he says, in the retreat I wept and cried for my sin. And I brought the oil and started to apply and pray. Every day at least 4 to 5 hours. I and my wife used to cry. Have mercy on us. I have sinned. I told my wife what happened. We both cried. Have mercy on us. Let not our sin affect our baby. The merciful God heard our prayer. At the end of the retreat, when we went back, the eyes of the child opened. Only then we realized the child's face is changing. The hair is not growing. And the whole body had a kind of hair started to change. And then we went back home, continued to pray. God is so merciful. God is so merciful. He forgave our sins. Now our daughter has become like a normal child. We cannot tell the whole world, but I am telling you, Father, Satan made my life a miserable life, made me a drunkard, and made me to destroy a little girl, and made my life a miserable one and my family. Sin is a terrible thing. It will take away all that God has given to you. But the Lord is merciful. The risen Savior says, repent. Come to your sins. Who are you? Where are you? What are you doing with your life? Yes. Repent and return to God.